The mysteries of the universe don't just lie in the vastness of space. NASA is delving into the uncharted depths of our own planet. This is what NASA is really looking for in the deep sea. With missions that seem straight out of science fiction, NASA is on a quest to uncover life, not in the stars, but beneath the ocean's surface, where extreme conditions may mirror the environments of distant moons and planets. At first glance, outer space and the deep sea might seem like polar opposites. One is a vast vacuum, while the other is filled with water. But when you look closer, you'll find that these two environments have more in common than you might expect. Think about it. Both are extreme environments that are incredibly hostile to human life. In space, astronauts face the vacuum, intense radiation, and microgravity. In the deep sea, explorers must contend with crushing pressures, total darkness, and temperatures that can range from near freezing to over 700 degrees Fahrenheit near hydrothermal vents. These similarities make the deep sea an ideal testing ground for space technologies and exploration strategies. NASA scientists can develop and test equipment designed to withstand extreme pressures and temperatures, which could later be adapted for use in space missions. For example, the same type of remote-operated vehicles used to explore the ocean floor could be modified to explore the surface of other planets or moons. But the connection goes even deeper. The isolation and confinement experienced by deep-sea explorers in underwater habitats closely mimic the conditions astronauts face during long-duration space missions. By studying how humans adapt to living and working in these underwater environments, NASA can gain valuable insights into the psychological and physiological challenges of space exploration. Now, here's where things get really interesting. One of NASA's primary goals in space exploration is the search for extraterrestrial life. But what if the key to finding life on other worlds lies hidden in Earth's oceans? The deep sea is home to some of the most extreme environments on our planet, and yet, life finds a way to thrive there. Take, for example, the incredible ecosystems that have developed around hydrothermal vents on the ocean floor. These underwater hot springs spew superheated water filled with toxic chemicals, creating an environment that seems utterly inhospitable to life. And yet, these vents are teeming with unique organisms that have evolved to not just survive, but thrive in these extreme conditions. NASA scientists are particularly interested in these hydrothermal vent communities because they offer a glimpse into how life might exist on other worlds. Imagine a place like Europa, one of Jupiter's moons, which scientists believe has a global ocean hidden beneath its icy surface. If hydrothermal vents exist on Europa's ocean floor, could they support life forms similar to those found in Earth's deep seas? By studying extremophilism, which are organisms that love extreme conditions found around hydrothermal vents, NASA researchers can develop a better understanding of the potential forms that alien life might take. They're learning about the limits of life as we know it, which in turn informs their search for life beyond Earth. But it's not just about finding alien-like creatures.
Hey, explorers! Ready to dive deeper into the unknown? We've got exclusive insights waiting for you. Subscribe to our newsletter now. Link in the description. Stay ahead of the tide and never miss a discovery. Now, enjoy the rest of the video.
The deep sea also provides clues about the origins of life on Earth itself. Some scientists believe that life may have first emerged around hydrothermal vents, where the unique chemical and energy conditions could have sparked the formation of the first organic molecules. By studying these environments, NASA hopes to piece together the puzzle of how life begins, which could help in identifying potential habitable environments on other planets. Now, let's dive deeper into one of the most fascinating aspects of NASA's deep sea research, astrobiology, the study of life in the universe. Remember those creatures we mentioned earlier, living around hydrothermal vents? They're part of a group called extremophiles, organisms that thrive in conditions that would be lethal to most life forms. The deep sea is home to some of the most remarkable extremophiles on Earth. Take, for example, the Pompeii worm. This creature lives in tubes near hydrothermal vents, where temperatures can reach up to 176 degrees Fahrenheit or 80 degrees Celsius. Its tail end is exposed to these scorching temperatures, while its head remains in cooler water around 72 degrees Fahrenheit or 22 degrees Celsius. How does it survive? Scientists believe it's partly due to a symbiotic relationship with bacteria that form a protective fleece on the worm's back. By studying these and other extremophiles, NASA scientists are expanding our understanding of the limits of life. This knowledge is crucial when considering the potential for life on other worlds with extreme conditions. Another intriguing phenomena NASA is studying in the deep sea is the formation of chemical gardens. These are self-assembling structures that form when certain metal salts are introduced into an alkaline solution. In the deep sea, similar structures form around hydrothermal vents, creating chimney-like formations. What's fascinating about these structures is that they create tiny compartments where complex chemical reactions can take place, reactions that some scientists believe could have led to the emergence of life on Earth. By studying these chemical gardens, NASA researchers hope to gain insights into how life might have originated on our planet and how it could potentially arise on other worlds. This research could help identify promising locations to search for life elsewhere in the solar system. As NASA looks for life beyond Earth, one of the key challenges is knowing what to look for. This is where the concept of biosignatures comes in. Biosignatures are any characteristic, element, molecule, or phenomenon that can be used as evidence of past or present life. In the deep sea, NASA scientists are studying various biosignatures, from specific chemical compounds produced by living organisms to particular patterns of mineral formation influenced by biological processes. By cataloging and understanding these biosignatures in Earth's extreme environments, researchers can better identify potential signs of life on other planets. For example, certain methane-producing microbes found in deep-sea environments create a specific ratio of carbon isotopes in the methane they produce. If similar isotope ratios were detected in the atmosphere of another planet, it could be a tantalizing clue that life might exist there. The deep sea isn't just a living laboratory for studying extreme life forms. It's also a vast archive of Earth's geologic history. NASA's exploration of the ocean floor is providing valuable insights into our planet's past and potentially the history of other worlds. One of the most significant geological discoveries of the 20th century was the concept of plate tectonics, and much of the evidence for this theory came from studying the deep sea floor. NASA's advanced mapping technologies are helping to create detailed maps of the ocean floor, revealing the patterns of seafloor spreading. At mid-ocean ridges, new crust is constantly being formed as magma rises from the Earth's mantle and cools. As this process continues, the seafloor spreads outward from these ridges. By studying this process, scientists can better understand how Earth's surface has changed over millions of years. For example, evidence suggests that Mars once had plate tectonics, and understanding Earth's tectonic processes could help unravel the geologic history of the Red Planet. The deep sea is also a treasure trove of information about Earth's past climate. Sediments that slowly accumulate on the ocean floor contain a record of past environmental conditions. By analyzing cores drilled from the seafloor, scientists can reconstruct Earth's climate history going back millions of years. NASA's interest in these paleoclimate records goes beyond just understanding Earth's past. By studying how our planet's climate has changed over time, scientists can better model and predict future climate changes. This research also informs our understanding of how climates might evolve on other planets, which is crucial for assessing their potential habitability. We've talked about hydrothermal vents in the context of extreme life, but they're also geological marvels in their own right. These underwater volcanic systems play a crucial role in the exchange of heat and chemicals between the Earth's interior and the oceans. NASA's study of these systems provides insights into how heat and energy move through planetary bodies. This is particularly relevant for icy moons like Europa or Enceladus, where internal heat could potentially sustain subsurface oceans and maybe even life. Moreover, the minerals deposited around hydrothermal vents can provide clues about the composition of the Earth's crust and mantle. Similar mineral deposits on other worlds could offer valuable information about their internal structure and composition. All of this fascinating research in Earth's oceans isn't just for the sake of understanding our own planet. NASA is using these insights to inform its exploration of ocean worlds beyond Earth. Europa, one of Jupiter's largest moons, is a prime target for NASA's search for extraterrestrial life. Why? Because beneath its icy surface, scientists believe Europa harbors a global ocean of liquid water. The lessons learned from exploring Earth's deep seas are directly applicable to the potential exploration of Europa's ocean. The extreme pressure, darkness, and isolation of the deep sea are similar to what we might expect in Europa's subsurface ocean. NASA is currently developing the Europa Clipper mission, set to launch in the 2020s. This spacecraft will conduct detailed reconnaissance of Europa, investigating its habitability. The instruments and techniques developed for deep-sea exploration on Earth are informing the design of this mission. For example, the study of how life thrives around Earth's hydrothermal vents is helping scientists determine what biosignatures to look for on Europa. If similar hydrothermal systems exist on Europa's ocean floor, they could potentially support life. Another intriguing ocean world is Enceladus, one of Saturn's moons. Enceladus is known for its dramatic geysers of water ice erupting from its south pole, hinting at a subsurface ocean. NASA's Cassini mission made some tantalizing discoveries about Enceladus, including the presence of organic compounds in its plumes. The study of extremophiles and chemical processes in Earth's deep oceans is helping scientists interpret these findings and assess the potential for life on Enceladus. Moreover, the technologies developed for sampling and analyzing fluids from Earth's hydrothermal vents could be adapted for future missions to sample Enceladus's plumes directly. While much of NASA's ocean world research focuses on worlds with subsurface water oceans, Titan, Saturn's largest moon, presents a different kind of challenge. Titan has lakes and seas on its surface, but they're not made of water. They're composed of liquid methane and ethane. Despite the different chemistry, many of the exploration techniques developed for Earth's oceans could be applied to Titan. For instance, the sonar systems used to map Earth's ocean floor could be adapted to chart the depths of Titan's hydrocarbon seas. Furthermore, studying how life adapts to extreme conditions in Earth's oceans helps scientists consider what forms life might take in the very different chemical environment of Titan. From the search for extraterrestrial life to the development of new technologies and the preparation of astronauts for long-duration missions, the deep sea is proving to be an invaluable testing ground for space exploration. Make sure you're subscribed to this channel.